In this video, I'm going to show you how you can set up your own custom workspace in AutoCAD. There's a couple of ways that you can get to your workspaces, and so I'll show you what those ways are. But first, let's talk about what a workspace is. So a workspace is setting your drawing screen up with the different menus and maybe toolbars and the different icons that you use and that you like to have readily available. It's kind of customizing the way you want your AutoCAD screen to work. So by default, if we come down here to the bottom of the screen, just above my clock, I'm going to click on that little gear. And these are the different workspaces that we have by default. AutoCAD gives us one called Drafting and Annotation. It's got a check mark next to it. So that shows you that that's the one we're using right now. We've got one called 3D Basics and 3D Modeling. When we get further along in the class and start learning 3D, we'll explore those two workspaces as well. I do have an option to save current as, and I can go to workspace settings, customize. I've got all of these options down here. So that's what workspaces are. We're actually going to create our own custom workspace. I'm going to show you how I like to have my workspace set up, just so you can see an option of how you might want to set up your workspace. Feel free to mix it up. You can do it however you'd like. The first thing that I'm going to do is on my quick access toolbar, which is right up here, I'm going to click the down arrow, and notice I've got a check mark next to everything that I can see, all the icons that I can see in my quick access toolbar. In a previous video, I unchecked open from web and save to mobile. I just never use those, so I don't want to see the icons up there. Plot, undo, redo. I have found the things that I really like to have up there is layer. When we learn about layers, it's nice to be able to have your layers right up top all the time. I use match properties and show menu bar. What show menu bar is going to do is it's going to give us that pull down menu. And so there's a few things that in our videos and in class, I'll be using the pull down menu way to find some commands. One more thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to check the one that says workspace. Go ahead and check one more and make it properties. I love having properties up there. That way, if I need to get into the properties of an object, I can just quickly click up there. So notice how it does it in the order in which you checked them. So if you wanted them in a different order, you'll just have to put the little check marks in a different order. I actually am going to uncheck workspace and then check workspace again so that my properties and match properties are right next to each other. Another thing that I'm going to do is come down here. Now this is my status bar. These are all the different status bar icons that we can have showing. I'm going to click on these three bars to customize this status bar. Sometimes it's nice to see the coordinates. So if I check that box, then I can see my coordinates as I move my mouse around. Notice that AutoCAD is doing the Cartesian coordinate system. So as I move, it's calculating where I am on the X, Y, and Z axis. So you might want to turn coordinates on or you can turn it off. This is all personal preference. One that you definitely want to turn on is called dynamic input. And if you look down here, it's this guy. You can see it looks like a little crosshair with a text box next to it. When I turn it off, it goes away. Dynamic input is what we're going to be using to, as we draw, it's going to prompt us and talk to us and tell us what it needs as we're doing the drawing. Units is a good one to have down there. So I put a little check mark next to units and it just tells me I'm in decimal units right now, but I can change it if I need to change my units. And I think that's just about it. Yeah, that's about all that I feel like I need down there. You can uncheck things that you don't feel like you need. I don't ever really use workspace switching. Annotation, we'll use that in a more advanced class, but you don't necessarily need it here. Check or uncheck, whichever ones you feel like you're going to need. Those are the ones that I like to set up. If you like to use toolbars or if your instructor is asking you to use toolbars, then this is another thing that you might do is you might click on tools, the pull down, now that we have the pull down, toolbars, AutoCAD, and we could come in here and check draw. We've got a draw toolbar, tools, toolbars, AutoCAD, and we can put checks next to the other ones that we want. Common ones that you'll see people use would be draw, modify, object snap and dimension up here. So you can put check marks next to the ones that you want to see on your screen. Once you have one toolbar up though, you can always right click and you get that same menu. So instead of having to go all the way back up to the tools pull down and then toolbars, then AutoCAD and see this list, you can right click on any existing icon on a toolbar to get that menu. So if your instructor wants you to have toolbars, or if you feel comfortable using toolbars, then that is something that you can set up in your workspace. I actually don't use toolbars, so I'm going to grab it by these two lines. I'm going to grab it, pull it out. That was what was called a dock toolbar. We can dock a toolbar onto the side, top, or bottom. This right here, now that I've grabbed it and I have it out in the middle, this is called a floating toolbar. With a floating toolbar, I can click on that X. I could have also just unchecked it from that list. So you may or may not want to use toolbars. That's going to depend on your own preference or your instructor's preference. Now that I've got my AutoCAD set up the way that I want it to be, I'm going to click in here, go up to my workspace. I'm going to pull it down. Notice I see the exact same thing in this one as I did down here. We're going to look for that gear. Ooh, where'd my gear go? Well, my gear was down there. But it's going to be the exact same information that we saw down there. I'm going to click right here, save current as, and I will call this you can name it whatever you'd like. You can put your first name, you can say whatever your course number is, maybe DFTG 1405 or whatever. Whatever your course number is, you can put it right in there and say save. And now when I come over here, my new one is in that list. So I can go back to drafting an annotation, or I can come into this workspace. So I've just saved the workspace set up exactly the way I like it.